Om Sri Gurubhyo Namaha. We will start with a prayer. Gurur Brahma, Gurur Vishnu, Guru Devo Maheshwaraha, Gurur Sakshat Parabrahma, Tasmai Shri Gurave Namaha. Namaste to R. Srinivas Rao Garu, the guest speaker of the day, and to all the viewers who have joined us live on Rishivatika YouTube channel today. I am Venkat Raghavan, host of this session. Welcome to Dr. Vedavyas Memorial Online Lecture Series being conducted by International Institute of Vedic Sciences, Rishivatika, and promoted by Vedavyasa Bharati Trust, USKFI, and Yoga Brotherhood of America with the blessings of our Pujya Guruji, Dr. Vedavyas. Today's topic is Chaturyuga Siddhanta in the Veda Vangmaya, an interesting subject related to the measurement of time and its significance to the mankind. This topic reminds me about Pujya Guruji, Dr. Vedavyasa's monumental book, Science of Time, and USKFI publication in the year 1997. So I would like to take this opportunity to introduce this book to you, to all. So Science of Time book has total 36 chapters and grouped into four parts. The first one being history of time, second being future time, evidence of science being the third and last, measuring time speeds. So I would like to explain a bit about chapter 5, Great Pyramids, Clock of the Worlds. The Great Pyramid of Egypt was for a long time considered as a tomb of King Cheops by archaeologists. This view is no longer taken seriously by the modern researchers in the light of new scientific advancements, which reveal many of the hidden mysteries which were hitherto unknown to the world of science. Undoubtedly, the Great Pyramid of Egypt is an astronomical structure and an architectural miracle. It encloses in its massive granite the diameter of the sun and moon, the angle of the pole star, the precession of equinoxes, and many other astronomical secrets of the solar system. The date of construction of pyramid is another mystery. Like in all Eastern civilizations, the European scholars in their short-sightedness had dated the pyramid to have been constructed between 3rd and 4th millennium BC. But the latest evidences indicate that this is monumental wonder of world in stone is most probably far more ancient than the Egyptian civilization itself. Many such topics are covered in great detail, and I would recommend this book to all the enthusiasts to keen to learn the science of time. I would like to now introduce the speaker of the day. It's a pleasure to introduce my dear friend, R. Srinivas Rao Garu. Srinivas is an ardent follower of Pujya Guruji, Dr. Vedavyas, since his childhood. He attended his first Sriman Narayana Yajna at the age of 4. This fire ritual is being performed for the last 49 years in Rajahmundry, Andhra Pradesh, during the auspicious Uttarayana Punyakala and Makara Sankranti festival. He practices palm history, numerology, and astrology. He loves reading philosophical texts from various authors. Currently, a series of articles on palm history, Hasta Samudrika Shastram in Telugu, are being published in Shubhavarta, USKFI monthly magazine. He introduced all his friends to the path of spirituality and Guruji. I am one among them. He's a graduate electronics engineer and is currently working in the IT industry as a business consultant. I now request Srinivas Garu to start the presentation. Please post your questions in the chat window and we shall take them towards the end of the session. Thank you.
Thank you, Raghavan. I would like to start my presentation with a small prayer. Guru Brahma, Guru Vishnu, Guru Devo Maheshwara, Guru Sakshat Parabrahma, Tasmai Shri Gurave Namaha, Suklam Bharadaram Vishnum, Sisivannam Chitrabhujam, Prasanna Vadanam Jayet, Sarva Vidno Vasantayet, Narayanam Namaskrutya Raram Chaiva Narottamam, देवीं सरस्वतीं व्यासं ततो जयमुदीरयेत् ज्ञानानन्दमयं देवं निर्मलस्फटिकाकृतिम् आधारं सर्वविद्यानां हयग्रीवोपास्महे. थैंक यू राघवन्.
The screen is yet to come. Srinivas. Yes.
Thank you, Raghavan. Om Sri Gurubhyo Namah. Today, we will try to understand the Tetrutri Yoga Siddhanta as per the Veda Vangmaya. The contents covered today are: time is cyclical and periodical, measurement of time, how are yugas formed, yugas, nature and behavior of human beings in these yugas, the saptadvipas in the four yugas, how is the cycle of the yugas dependent on the planetary positions, what are the manvantaras, yugas and the avataras that occur across, the dasavataras, Eka Visanti avataras and 24 avatar of Sri Mahavishnu. We will also try to understand the Manus, the Manvantaras and the Saptarishis. Kshatriya Yuga Siddhanta is one of the fundamental sciences to understand the Sanatana Dharma as per the Veda Vangmaya. Veda Vangmaya also talks about the Avatara Siddhanta, Karma Siddhanta, Punarjanma Siddhanta, and Panchabhuta Siddhanta also. It is also interesting to note that the Avatara Siddhanta is interlinked with the Chaturyuga Siddhanta. As my friend mentioned across, the science of time is very close and is to be understood with this Chaturyuga Siddhanta. We all experience sunrise and sunset every day. And this in turn gives us to the formation of days. The weeks are the varas, pakshas, masas, and the samvatsara, and which we call as the 12 months, which is 360 days of the solar year. The Veda Vangmaya defines the Virat Purusha, the personification of time as Chakrakara. It is said, Rutuhu Sudarsana Kala in the Sri Vishnu Sahasranama Stotra. Sri Purusha Sukta says, Prishchesta Lakshmishtapatnav, अहोरात्रे पार्श्वे नक्षत्राणि रूपम् अश्वनो व्यात्तम् इष्टम् मनीषाणाम्. Both these slokas clearly tells us that it is Sri Mahavishnu who rules this entire creation in the form of time. The Bhagavad Gita also mentions kalosmi loka kshaya krut pravruddho in the Virat Purusha Sandarsana Yoga. We will try to understand the measurement of time. In the Surya Siddhanta, an astrophysical mathematical book, this is the concise book of Sri Surya Bhagavan's initiation to the Asura Maya in the closing years of the Krita Yuga. We find the measurements of time as below. 15 nimisha, or the blinks of an eye, is one kasta. 13 kastas is one kala. 13 kalas is one muhurta. 30 muhurtas is 60 gadiyas. 60 gadiyas is equal to one day. 30 days is equal to one month or a masa. 12 months is equal to one year. And the subject has been taken with the help of the book Mana Sanatana Dharmam and Jatiya Vidya by Pooja Gurudev Dr. Vedavyas. We will further expand the understanding and of the measurement of time progressively, where we have understood up to 24 hours and 12 months. Now, we will also understand why time is cyclical and periodical in its nature. The time of Brahma and the Yugas, as mentioned in the Sri Vishnu Purana, is a very, very vast subject. I am a student of this subject and I am trying to present with the limited learning that I could learn and understand from the writings and teachings of Pujya Gurudev. 24 hours is equal to one day. 7 days is one vara or one week. 2 weeks or 15 days is a paksha. 2 pakshas or 30 days is one masa or one month. 6 months or 180 days is one ayana or half day or half night of devas, where 2 ayanas or 360 days is a samara samvatsara or one solar year or one day of the devatas. Now, as per certain schools of study, Krita Yuga is 17,28,000 years. Treta Yuga is 12,96,000 years. Dwapara Yuga is 8,64,000 years. Kali Yuga is 4,32,000 years. Mahayuga is 43,20,000 years. Is one celestial year or the Deva Yuga. We also understand the combination or the total of the four yugas, the Kali, Dwapara, Treta and Treta Yuga, and the Krutaya is one Manmantra. One mantra is 71 Mahayugas. One day or one night or 14 is equal to 14 one mantra, Manmantras, where 14 Manmantras is also equal to the one day of the Brahma, which is the Srushti Kalpa. When we have the day and the night, the combined number 28 Manmantras, where we have the Srushti Kalpa and the Pranaya Kalpa, which is equal to 28 Manmantras. The Brahma Samvatsara is equal to 360 such Brahma Kalpas. The life of Brahma is 100 such Brahma Samvatsaras. We have now the total year of 293040 into 10 to the power of 9 such human years is equal to 100 Brahma Samvatsaras or one lifespan of the Brahma. We will now understand the measures of time in detail to the current date. Padma Sambhava is the present Brahma. 51st year of the present Brahma is running. Sveta Varaha Kalpa is the name of the present Kalpa. 6 Manvantras have been completed so far. And the 7th Manvantara, which we call as Vaivaswata Manvantara, is running. In the current Manvantara, 27 Mahayugas have been completed so far. And we are now in the 28th Mahayuga. Even in this 28th Mahayuga, the Krita, Treta, Dwapara Yugas are completed. And now we are in the Kali Yuga. Sri Vedavyasa Maharshi, in his Mahabharata Itihasa, mentions the onset of the Kali Yuga, the present Kali Yuga, as 18th February 3102 BC at midnight, when all the 8 planets have conjuncted in the Aries or the Mesha Rasi, which is when Lord Sri Krishna has left his mortal bodies to the celestial abode. Or the Vishnupadam. Yasmin Krishno Divam Yadaha Tasmin Yeva Tada Ahani Pratipannam Kaliyugam. It is also to be noted that according to certain great saints and scholars, this Kaliyuga has already ended by the year 1998 with the span of 5098 years, and we are now in the Yuga Sandhi Kala. Now we will try to understand the definition of the Yuga. The word Yuga in the Veda Vangmaya has been used in several contexts with several meanings of the span and the meaning. According to Vedanga Jyotisha, as the span of 5 years is also called an Yuga. Ardha Paksha, Ardha Masa or a Paksha is also called as a Yuga. According to Padma Purana and Sri Vishnu Purana, 12,000 such years is one Deva Yuga. Yesha Dvada Sahasri Yugakya Parigirtada, says the Vishnu Purana. According to Mahabharata, the human Kali Yuga span is given as Yugam Bhavetat Vatsara panchaketana. We all today understand and call the span of 360 days as samvatsara. The Mahabharata also defines that it is not 1 year, that there are such the samvatsara, anuvatsara, parivatsara, yudvatsara and idavatsara. We will understand the context in the next slide. What is termed as 1000 yugas when multiplied by the above 5 is the human span of the Kali Yuga, thus by giving us the span of 5000 years. Sahasra Yuga Pariyantam Aryat Brahmano Vidahu. In the Brahmakalpa Ganipida, in the Vedas and in the Aranya Parva of the Mahabharata, Sri Vedavyasa Maharshi gives us the understanding how do we calculate the span of the remaining 3 yugas. Chatvari, Trini, Dve, Chaitam Yeva, Prudadeshu Yidakramam, which means that 2 times the span of the Kali Yuga is the Dvapara Yuga, 3 times the span of the Kali Yuga is the Treta Yuga, 4 times the span of the Kali Yuga is the Kriti Yuga. Now we will also understand how and when will the yugas change. We have understood the formation of the 4 yugas, the span of the 4 yugas, and to some extent onto the Manvantaras. In the astronomical textbook Neelakanta Vyakhya, it is mentioned yada chandrascheti sarva grahopalakshanam kumutva sarva graha yogehi yugam, which means that when all the 8 planets including Rahu conjunct in one of the zodiac sign, then we have the onset of a new yuga or the yuga prarambha. Now when on what time does the yuga change? We will understand that as per the Surya Pragnapti Sutra, Vedanga Dosha and the Surya Siddhanta clearly gives us the understanding when the new yuga exactly starts with. If the 8 planetary conjunction occurs at the dawn or the Brahmi Muhurta, then the Kriti Yuga is formed. Then at the midday, when the sun is at the zenith, we will understand the zenith of the sun being at the midday, then the Treta Yuga is formed. At the dusk, then Dwapara Yuga is formed. At the midnight, which is the nadir point or the lowest point of sun, then the Kali Yuga begins. We will now try to understand the account of evolution of the mankind and the traits or the behaviors in these Chaturyugas. We will now try to understand with the Kriti Yuga or the Satya Yuga. It is also understood from the various texts that Kriti Yuga was the times when the humanity was just like a just born small child. It is in these ages that Maharshis have performed tapas and have discovered the Vedas in the mantra form, and that is why they are called as seers. They have never claimed themselves as the discoverers or inventors of any subject. It is also interesting to note that the Maharshis have moved freely from one place to the other and have sanctified those places, converting them as the Punya Kshetras, which we call them as today. It is a very simple fact that the Parabrahma was accessible to them because of their purity and the austerities they have observed. It is also to be noted that the weather was uniform throughout the year. We have Vasishta, Atri, Bharadwaja, Agastya, Gautama, Brihaspati, Vamadeva, Bhrigu are few of the prominent Maharshis of the Kriti Yuga. Of all of this, Narayan Rishi is the most prominent of all. If I may, Vasishta Maharshi has given us the Yoga Shastra. Bharadwaja Maharshi was the Rishi who has given the Ayurveda Shastra. And I have also learned that see Gurudev has seen the unpublished manuscript of Vimana Shastra written by Sri Bharadwaja Maharshi in the Harvard University. Excuse me. Agastya Maharshi is a Chiranjeevi, and Agastya Maharshi is also one of the pioneers in the Ayurveda and one of its subjects of Rasa Vaidya. Gautama Maharshi is famous, who has given us for the Nyaya Sutra. Bhriga Maharshi is one of the prominent Maharshis and has given us the Bhriga Samhita, which is an ancient text. Brihaspati is the Kulaguru of the Devadas. Now we will also understand that Sriman Narayana or the Sri Mahavishnu has appeared as the Matsya Avatara and has saved the present Manu and the Saptarishis from the Pralaya Kalpa and has given back the Vedas as initiation to them. We will also understand that this Matsya Avatara is different, which occurs at the Kalaya Kalpa Pralaya also. This is the Manvantara Kalpa. There are pralayas that happen at the end of each yuga, at each Manvantara and the Kalpas. This Matsya Avatara is the most recent of them all. It is also interesting to understand and learn that Lord Narayana has appeared as the Matsya Avatara, as which we have understood just before. The Varaha, the wild boar, Sri Narasimha, the human lion form, the Vamana Avatara, or the dwarf in the Krita Yuga. We also have an ancient text by name Sri Vishnu Purana, which is different from the Vishnu Purana written by Sri Vedavyasa Maharshi. We have this Sri Vishnu Purana written by Sri Parasara Maharshi, who is the father of Sri Vedavyasa Maharshi. This Vishnu Purana clearly gives us the details about the creation of the Devatas and the Asuras, churning of the Milky Way, and we also understand the Kurma Avatara has occurred in the same context, the birth of Sri Mahalakshmi, Chandra Avatarana, Dhanvantari Avatarana, and the birth of the Elixir are also part of this Satyuga. Sri Vishnu Purana and Vamana Puranas record in detail about the first one Manu, whom we understand as Swayambhu Manu, and the other Maharshis, Emperors, Kings and the dynasties of this Krita Yuga. It is to be understood that Krita Yuga runs on the Brahmana Dharma and Tapas was the way of life. We will now try to understand the traits and the behavior of the mankind in the Treta Yuga. In the Treta Yuga, we find the kings from the Surya dynasty. Few of them, Ikshvaku, Amsumanta, Bhagiratha, Dilipa, and Sagara, to name a few, have ruled this entire world. We all know from Srimad Ramayana that Lord Sri Rama was the last emperor of the Surya dynasty. According to the Ashtadasha Mahapuranas, the Sapta Dvipas, which we will understand as Jambu Dvipa, Pulaksha Dvipa, Shalmana Dvipa, Kusha Dvipa, Krauncha Dvipa, Shaka Dvipa, and Pushkara Dvipa have been ruled by the kings of the Surya dynasty. We also understand from Srimad Ramayana that Lord Sri Rama has ruled his kingdom with utmost dharma in parallels with the Satyuga and is still known today as Sri Rama Rajya. We will also find it that the quality of the human being started deteriorating from the tapas and the austerity. Thereby, civilizations have started expanding, where men started settling across, found cities, thereby led to the town planning. And money and coin minting also originated in this yuga. And that led to the commerce. It is also interesting from the few of the events of the Treta Yuga that Sri Agastya Bhagavan has gulped the ocean in one Achamana. We also have a detailed account of Ganga Avatarana in Srimad Ramayana, where King Bhagiratha has brought the sacred Ganga to this earth. We will also like to learn that Sagara had 60,000 tons. Now in the same Ganga Avatarana Gada, when the Yajna Pasu was hidden by the Indra in the Kapila Maharishi's Ashrama, in order to find that, the 60,000 sons have started digging the earth. Now, very few of us know the fact that which is being dug on earth is called as Khatam in Sanskrit, and that has led to the formation of the Bay of Bengal. Now, again, after this Treta Yuga, which I have mentioned earlier, there was a deluge and most of the earth had got submerged except for the high peaks of the Himalayas. This Treta Yuga runs on the Kshatriya Dharma and Yajnas were performed. I have requested and mentioned earlier that the sun is at the zenith when the Treta Yuga is formed. Now we also understand this Treta Yuga marks the highest points of growth of humanity in civilization and science and technologies in various aspects. We learn from the Srimad Ramayana that they had circular and round objects flying from one plane to the other, which we call as one loka to the other. It is to be understood from Srimad Ramayana that Sri Rama has traveled back to Ayodhya after Ramana Samhara in this vehicle. And Sri Hanuman also mentions in the Sundara Kanda that he has found a circular object which would fly to other planes, parked in a larger space, which we call as the hangars. This was very detailedly explored by the Russian scientist V. Zaitsev and has given detailed accounts in his doctoral thesis, Temples and Spaceships. Now, we will also understand that in this Treta Yuga, due to severe earthquakes and volcano eruptions, the Earth's axis has changed. Thereby, it has resulted in the abnormal rotation of the Earth. Due to this, the time durations or the Kala Gati has changed. When the Kala Gati of the Earth has changed, the lifespan of the humans also got reduced. And then seasons started appearing. And one of the most important factors is that we also find that the Saraswati River has disappeared in this Yuga. As we have understood earlier, Treta Yuga is the zenithal point in various aspects of the Sanatana Dharma. And it is in this Treta Yuga that Vedic rituals like Yajna Kratu have begun. It is the first time that humanity has witnessed the temples being built according to science and the idols were consecrated. The science of temple worship has begun and has flourished. We have the science of temple worship, which is a prescribed format even today in various temples, including Sri Venkateswara Temple in Tirumala. We have Suprabheta Agama, Vaikanas Agama, பாஞ்சராத்திர ஆகமா சைவாகமா அண்ட் சாக்தே ஆகமா ஒன் ஆஃப் மை யோகா பிரதர்ஸ் ஸ்ரீசரன் ஹாஸ் ஆல்ரெடி டச் பேஸ்ட் ஆன் திஸ் ஆகம சாஸ்திராஸ் அண்ட் தேர் டீச்சிங்ஸ் டு அஸ் வி வில் மூவ் டு தி துவாபர யுகா வி நோ துவாபர யுகா வென் எனிஒன் சேஸ் இட் ஸ்ரீ கிருஷ்ண பகவான் who was very very predominant character in the Dwapara Yuga. Now we understand that from the Treta Yuga humanity has migrated and has gradually moved on to the Vaishya Dharma of the way of life. In Dwapara Yuga it was mostly ruled by the kings of the Chandra dynasty. Lord Sri Krishna has appeared in the Yadu Vamsa and is also known as Yadu Vamsa Tilaka. We know that Sri Vedavyasa Maharshi, who is the head of the Parama Guru Mandali or the Eternal Guru's Council, has appeared in the ending years of the Dwapara Yuga. He, with his kind-heartedness, has given us the Mahabharata, which we all know, the Itihasa. He has then divided the then undivided Veda into four Vedas, which we understand as Ruk, Yajus, Sama, Adharvana Vedas, composed the 18 Mahapuranas. It may be interesting fact to note that the current Vedavyasa Maharshi is known as Badarayana, and Dwapara Yuga is the age of Dhanas, where Suvarna Dhana, Kanya Dhana, Godhana and Bhudhanas were performed to very extensively. And we know that this Yuga ran on the Vaishya Dharma. Commerce started greening up. We know when money is there, gradually selfishness would come in. And as the selfishness grew among the men, they started trespassing each other. This has emulated in the accumulation of huge wealth, and subsequently people started losing the principle of the Dharma. And we know, unfortunately, that the Kurukshetra war that was fought between the Kauravas and Pandavas has resulted in the loss of millions of lives. Also in the end of the Kali Yuga, of the Dwapara Yuga, the Yadu dynasty has been completely wiped off. And the Dwapara, the residential abode on this earth of Sri Krishna, also has got submerged. We also understand and take away that Dwapara Yuga runs on the Vaishya Dharma, and danas and donations were given in this Yuga. We will now move on to the Kali Yuga. Accounts of evolution of mankind and traits in the Chaturyugas and in relation to the Kali Yuga. Sri Vedavyasa Maharshi has given us in the Mahabharata and the Bhavishya Purana the rulers, the dynasties and the rulership times that would rule the span of 5,000 years in India. We also understand from the Mahabharata that Parikshit Maharaj was the first Maharaj or the emperor of this Kali Yuga. And Dr. Vedavyas Guruji, in his doctoral thesis, the astronomical dating of the Mahabharata war, mentions the Dana Sasana given by the king Janamejaya, who is the son of the Parikshit Maharaj. It is very important for us today to understand that at the beginning of this Yuga Sandhi, World War I has been fought and millions of lives have been lost. Again, India got its independence in the year 1947. And this is the conjunction period of the two Yugas or the Yuga Sandhi, where there is no king, or it is called, where it is the Arajaka Yoga. according to certain saints and great scholars, on 4th of May 1999, the 8th planetary conjunction has occurred in the house of Aquarius or the Kumbharasi, marking the onset of the Aquarian age or the Kriti Yuga. To my learning and understanding, we are in the Sandhikala, where there are so many catastrophes occurring today, and the Satyuga shall dawn upon us with the appearance of Sri Kalki Avatar, who is the last of the 10 avatars. And the details of all these accounts has been clearly given to us in the Mahabharata and Sri Vishnu Purana. Kaliyuga runs on the Sutra Dharma, and Bhagavan Nama Japa is the way of life. It is also meant to be, I have learned and understood that in Treta Yuga, Sri Ranganatha used to be worshipped. In Dwapara Yuga, Madhava used to be worshipped. And we all know Kalo Venkata Nayaka, and Lord Sri Venkateswara is the only refuge for all of us to save us from this, the traits and the negative characteristics of this Kali Yuga. Moving on, we will now try to understand the Dasavatara of Sri Mahavishnu. As I have mentioned earlier, there is an eternal and astronomical relationship how and when the Dasavataras occur across. The Matsavatara occurs in the Meenarasi, in the Krita Yuga. Kurmavatara occurs in the Karkataka Rasi, in Krita Yuga. The Varahavatara occurs in the Makara Rasi, in Krita Yuga. Sri Narasimha Avatara occurs in the Simha Rasi, in Krita Yuga. Vamana Avatara occurs in, again in the Makara Rasi, in the Krita Yuga. Sri Parashurama Avatara occurs in the Mithuna Rasi, in Treta Yuga. Sri Rama Avatara comes in the Karkata Rasi, in the Punarvasu Nakshatra. Vidyapada in the Karkataka, the Cancer, in the Treta Yuga. Sri Krishna Bhagavan comes in the Vrishabha Rasi, with the Rohini as his birth star, in the Dwapara Yuga. In Kali Yuga, we have the Buddha Avatara coming in the Tula Rasi, and Sri Kalki Avatara, which we have understood in the earlier side, in the Aquarius or the Kumbha Rasi. It is to be understood and learned that the above 10 avataras are Purna Avataras of Sri Mahavishnu. And Matsya, Kurma, Varaha, Narasimha and Vamana are the eternal, are the permanent avataras of the above 10 avataras, and they will exist till the end of the Brahma Kalpa. We will also understand the account of the 21 other avataras of Sri Mahavishnu. Haigriva Avatara, who is the Jnana Pradada, Paramahamsa Avatara, Jaganmohani Avatara, who has come during the churning of the Milky Ocean, Naranarayana Avatara is one of the prominent avataras, Sanaka, Sanatana, Sanandana, and Sanatkumara. As we all know today, we call it as Hinduism, but it is predominantly the Sanatana Dharma, as being given to us by the Sanatana Maharshi, who is a Chiranjeevi. We also have the Kapila Maharshi. Kapila Maharshi has given us the Sankhya Yoga. Again, we have Dattatreya Avatara. Dattatreya is one of the Chiranjeevis. And there are various forms and incarnations which are very well believed and followed even today. We all understand and worship Sri Shirdi Sai as Dattatreya, Sri Nrusimha Sarathi, and Sri Pada Vallabha are also the incarnations of Dattatreya, Manikya Prabhu, to name a few of them. We also understand Vyasa Maharshi is one of the incarnation of Sri Mahavishnu or the Lord Vishnu. Now the current Vyasa is the Badarayana. We have Ambarisha. We understand in detail about the Ambarisha Maharshi as a great follower and is one of the Pratasmaraniyas along with Prahlad Narada Ambarisha of Sri Mahavishnu. We understand the detailed account of Prudhu Chakravarti. We understand the Bhagavata Purana clearly tells us the great activities Sri Prudhu Chakravarti has taken across. He has milked the earth in the cow farm and has leveled the earth, making it suitable for agriculture, and has given us, the entire humanity, the food, the Anna Parabrahma Swarupa, and has given us the sustenance of the people in that yuga. Vrushabhadeva. We know from the astrology that Vrushabha is an indication of the Dharma and Hari. These are the highlighted avatars apart from the Dasavatara of Sri Mahavishnu. We will now try to understand the 24 forms of Sri Mahavishnu. Kesava, Narayana, Madhava, Govinda, Vishnu, Madhusudana, Trivikrama, Vamana, Sridhara, Rishikesha, Padmanabha, Damodara, Sankarsana, Vasudeva, Pradyumna, Anuruddha, Purushottama, Adokshita, Narasimha, Achyuta, Janardana, Upendra, Hari, Sri Krishna. May I also submit that what we read as Sri Krishna is different from the Sri Krishna of the Dasavataras. We also have Narayana, we also have Vasudeva, and we also have Narasimha. These are the 24 forms of Sri Mahavishnu, which anyone and everyone in the Sanatana Dharma recites during his Achamana for the purification or the sanctification at the beginning of each prayer. We will also try to understand and submit the list of the 14 Manvantaras and the Saptarishis in each Manvantara. Swayambhu Manu was the first Manu. Marichi, Atri, Angirasa, Pulaha, Kratu. Pulaha and Vasishta are the Saptarishis. The second Manvantara being Swarochisha Manu. Urjastambha, Agni, Prana, Danti, Rishabha, Nishchara and Charivarivan are the Saptarishis. The third is Uttama Manu and Kaukindi, Karundi, Daraya, Sankha, Pravihita, Mita and Samhita are the Saptarishis. Tapasa are Tamasa Manu, Jyotirdhama, Pridhu, Kavya, Chaitra, Agni, Vanaka and Pivara are the Maharshis. The fifth Manvantara is Revata Manu and Hiranyaroma, Vedasri, Urdhavahu, Vedavahu, Sudaman, Parjanya and Mahamuni are the Saptarishis. Chakshusha Manvantara, where we have the Chakshusha Manu, Sumedha, Viraja, Havishmant, Uttama, Madhu, Abhinavan are the Saptarishis. The seventh Manvantara, which we are in the current Manvantara, mentions as Vaivaswata Manu as the current Manu, and the current Saptarishis are Kashyapa, Atri, Vasishta, Vishwamitra, Gautama, Jamadagni, Bharadvaja are the Saptarishis. The eighth Manvantara, which is Savarni Manu, Deeptimanta, Galava, Parasurama, Kripa, Drauni, are the Ashwadhama, Vyasa and Rushyasringa are the Saptarishis. The ninth Manvantara is Dakshasavarni Manvantara, which we call as Dakshasavarni Manvantara, who is the Manu. Savana, Dyutimanta, Bhavya, Vasu, Medhadi, Jyotishman, and Satya are the Saptarishis. The tenth Manvantara is Brahma Savarni Manvantara. Avishman, Sukriti, Satya, Abhamruti, Navaha, Abhamrutija, and Aparmrutijas are the seven Saptarishis. The 11th Manvantara is Dharma Savarni Manvantara, Nishchara, Agni Tejas, Vabushman, Vishnu, Arani, Havishman, and Anaga are the Saptarishis. The 12th Manvantara is the Rudra Savarni Manvantara, Tavasvi, Sudabas, Tapovamurti, Taporadi, Tapodriti, Tapodjuri, Tapodhan are the Saptarishis. The 13th Manvantara or Rauchya Manvantara or Deva Savarni Manvantara, Nirmoha, Vasta, Tvatat Deshini, Nishpa Prakma, Nirustaka, Dhritamata, Avyaya, and Sudabas are the Saptarishis. The 14th and the last is the Indra Savarni Manvantara, Agni Bahu, Suchi, Sukra, Magada, Grida, Yukta, Ajita are the Saptarishis. With this, I conclude my paper on the Chaturyuga Siddhanta, and I sincerely thank Sri Dattatreya Garu, Sri G.S. Raj Garu, Sri Y.V.S. Giri Garu, and my friend and colleague Sri Raghavan for giving this opportunity and helping me in all ways to submit this paper. Thank you.
Thank you, Srinivas Garu. It was a wonderful talk, and it has been great to learn about the Chaturyuga Siddhanta, and as well, you have taken us through the journey of Chaturyuga Siddhanta so lively, with the ways of life of each yuga and few interesting facts about Bangala Katham and etc. according to the Veda Vangmaya. I would like to wait for any questions. I would request, if you have any questions, please post them in the chat window. But I have a question, with your permission. I wanted to understand, generally it is told that the dharma, which is on the four padas in each of these yugas, if you could explain what are those four dharmas and what kind of dharmas does deteriorate according to each of these yugas, if you can help us understand that, that would be great.
Thank you, Raghava. The four padas of the dharma are ahimsa, which is not to trouble any living creation, satya, not the truth, but the eternal truth, asteya, or not to steal or take away anything that belongs to the other person, and to perform tapas, are the four padas of the dharma as per the Veda Vangmaya. Now we understand in the Kritiga, the dharma was on the four padas, where people performed tapas, never stole anything from the others. They always contemplated on the satya or the eternal truth and followed the ahimsa. Now, when humanity migrated to the Treta Yuga, people lost the performance of tapas, and then dharma has that on the three padas. Now again in the Dwapara Yuga, we know It was on the Vaishya Dharma, and people started encroaching each other. They lost Asteya, not to steal from the other. And in Kali Yuga, we know all the four, three padas has been lost, and it is only Ahimsa that was left over. So that is how we understand the evolution and the Chaturyuga Siddhanta into the context of the today's life. Thank you, Raghav.
Thank you, Srinivas. So there has been only a couple of acknowledgements. There are no questions from the viewers. I hope this talk was very clear and precise to the content. So Jyoti Garu has been acknowledging that. Thank you for a very interesting topic. Curious to know what is Veda Vangmaya? What does it contain? So if you could highlight that, that would be useful.
Namaste. Madam, Veda Vangmaya is a holistic understanding of all the teachings of the Vedas. Veda Vangmaya is not a singular subject. We understand Jyotisha, Ayurveda, Ardhashastra, and so many other aspects of the Vedas and their teaching to us. All that is being taught in the Vedas is singularly termed as Veda Vangmaya. And in order to understand the Veda Vangmaya, Dr. Vedayas Guruji also says that as in a lotus flower, as the petals are arranged in a very systematic way, and we should understand each science in relevance to the next science and not as a standalone science. Like Ayurveda is related with astrology. Like G.S. Raju Garu has mentioned, where as soon as a person comes across, it would be great to see that the person acknowledging the person would take his date of birth and just say, boss, this is what it is. So likewise, I've given a small example, but Mantra Shastra, Jyotisham, Agama Shastra are all the part of the Veda Vangmaya, and we should be able to learn and understand them in correlation with the balance or the other sciences. This is the Veda Vangmaya. Thank you.
Thank you, Srinivas Garu. So I would like to now thank once again Srinivas Garu for this wonderful talk on the Chaturyuga Siddhanta. And I would like to make an announcement about the tomorrow's topic in the Dr. Vedavyasa Memorial Online Lecture Series would be on Spirituality, A Pathless Path, by Dr. K.S.M.S. Raghavarao Garu at 11:30 a.m. IST. We would thank all the viewers who have joined us live on Rishivatika YouTube channel today and request everyone to subscribe to the channel for the latest notifications on all the future talks. Stay tuned. Thank you.